Yes, I'm still alive. Are you ready? You're going to have to listen fast because I'm going to talk fast because I got a lot to say. I'm going to do it in a little short time. It's summertime. That means when it's daylight, I like to be working outside. And when it's not daylight, I'm tired and I want to go to sleep. So that's why I don't edit videos. But I don't have to do hay this year. And I think with the changes in YouTube right now, I really need to get on top of putting up videos. So I'll try. Okay? No guarantees. I got shop recovery videos to go, which is very little editing. Just kind of hack, chop, put it up there, be done. All of you guys that made donations, thank you very much. I really appreciate it. I know you haven't heard from me. Even you guys who have sent in your money for your stickers haven't heard from me. Now, they call that ADD, but way back when, my mother called it absent-minded. So, saying, you know, yeah, that's I've always been that way. So, I've got all the previous 2-3 years of video to put up. There's a lot of money available. I just have to work to get it. And I'll tell you what to do with any money you want to send here in just a minute. But for projects, here's what's going on. That is a 200-gallon tank for a fire suppression unit brush truck. You won't get to see that. That is the 500-gallon option. That is the 1980 Chevy truck that the guy wants it all put on. Not both tanks, just one. That is the 58 GMC I just snagged. 58 GMC Fleetside with a 270 and a 3-speed on the column. Needs some few things. This is a 59 Ford that used to have a 352. Now it's just got a bunch of cast iron sitting underneath the hood. That's on Craigslist. That needs to go away and go away fast. Jimmy Blue, still here. I got to polish up the chrome and get something on it to keep it from rusting away on me. Oh, there's the new temporary shop. Old Blue, brakes all the way around. We're talking wheel cylinders, drums, shoes, master cylinder, brake booster, everything but the hard lines. This Honda here, it needs a little help. Got it mostly done. And then there's crusty old granddad's cab. Got to get the back wall welded on that. And there's crusty old granddad's frame. The engine's going to the engine shop. Tranny's done. Got to put a brake booster on there, run the brake lines, get that all taken care of, and it's time for the body work to get done. The chicken coop, you can see, is still a mess. One thing we didn't see over the winter, you look at the front side of this barn, and it looks like everything is okay, because that lean-to part is okay. But halfway back, it's laying on top of a truck. So I got to get that jacked up and dig that truck out of there. And the aviary is still down. The arbors, my buddy Scrapper Joe called me up, says, you want a snow smash carport? And me being the glutton for punishment that I am, said, sure, hey, you know. So I went over and picked that up, and I did this, the new arbor frame. So I guarantee you, once I put the livestock panels on top of that, and the vines grow over the top of it, it can put as much snow on there as it wants. That is not coming down. The backhoe is still dead. The Sprint died. It gave up number 3 cylinder. So, and my friend Dale, who has the foundry that we did the pour on the power steering cap lid, his wife had a PT Cruiser, and she's been gone for 3 years, passed away. And the PT sat out there, and unbeknownst to him, it was leaking. So he opened it up, and there was an inch of water laying on the floor, and the interior covered with mold. So they cleaned it out, let it dry out, covered it up, and next year he opened it up and it's all the same thing all over again. So he made me an offer I couldn't refuse. So this thing was just the steering wheel was solid mold, the door panels were solid mold, the headliner had the wow, what happened there? The camera didn't like that. I guess I won't show you that. Anyway, I now have a PT Cruiser. And you know what? I actually like it. Okay, those of you guys who've made the donations, again, thanks a lot. And there's always somebody worse off than you are. Over the course of years, people would send me these things. Hey, could you put my... Or they would just put their GoFundMe link, you know, in the comment section, of which I would boot them. And some people would ask if I would do it. And, you know, there's so many stupid reasons why people want GoFundMe accounts and things. Well, one of the requests, I always go and look to see what they're up to. And one of the requests is somebody that's worse off than you and I. A lot of you guys have asked about making donations for this channel. And I'm going to tell you now that if you want to send something to me, send it to Coco Cabana. He calls himself Cape Cod Cuda. His channel is Coco Cabana. His name's Steve. And he's a car guy. I'll put a link down in the description. Go watch the video from a year ago. Get his story. Now, he was in a house fire when he was 2 years old. Got burnt real bad. Lost fingers. And they told him so many things that he wouldn't be able to do. And now he's working on cars and was restoring cars. And then he got cancer on his face. There's a link to the video of that. And if you can't handle raw meat looking things, don't watch it. But if you really want to see what's going on. But the greatest thing about Steve is his attitude. It's just amazing to me that this guy is like, you know, he's almost like, ah, no big deal. I know that's not the truth, that it's no big deal. But his whole persona is just... You have to watch the videos to see what I'm talking about, so go watch them. I'm going to put a link to his GoFundMe account down there, and I'll be sending something to it myself. So anyway, like I said, if you want to donate, donate that direction, because there's always somebody worse off than you. Anyway, that's the update for now. The next few videos, I'm going to run through all the shop recovery videos until that's done to this point. And from then, they'll just have to come in as I do things. I'm going to try to put up a lot more videos. Like they say, they change the parameters and algorithms and things on YouTube. And guys like us are now starting to get a bigger share of the market. Okay, that's it for the update. Comments below. See ya.